Friends, here is a question on the screen. A student was awarded certain marks in an examination. However, after re-evaluation, his marks were reduced by 40% of the marks that he were originally awarded to him, so that the new mark score now became 96. How many marks did student lose after re-evaluation? So friends, a student was awarded certain marks in an examination, but after re-evaluation his marks were reduced by 40% of that of the marks originally awarded. So first we will assume that let the originally awarded marks be 100, and his marks were reduced by 40% after re-evaluation. It means it is reduced by 40, so his new marks will be 60. But it is said that his new score is 96. So when his new score is 60, the original marks are 100. So if his new score is 96, what will be the original marks? So we multiply these two and divide by the first one, since this is the direct variation. So it is 96 multiplied by 100 divided by 60. So friends, that is equal to 160. It means the original marks were 160 and his new score is 96. Therefore 160 minus 96, so that is equal to 64. So his score was reduced by 64 marks after the re-evaluation. So here the question is, how many marks did the student lose? So he lose 64 marks. Friends, the next question is, Aryan got 350 marks and Vidya scored 76% marks in the same test. If Vidya scored 296 marks more than that of Aryan, what were the maximum marks of the test? Here friends, Aryan got 350 marks and Vidya, she scored 296 marks more than Aryan's marks, and so it will be 350 plus 296, and that is equal to 646. So Vidya got 646 marks. And this 646 is what? It is 76%. So we can say that 76% is 646 marks. Then what will be the 100%, that is the maximum marks of the test? So multiply this two, 646 multiplied by 100 divided by 76. And if you solve this, you will get it as 850 marks. And so the maximum marks of the test are 850 marks. Friends, here is a question on the screen. In an election, only two candidates contested. 30% of the registered votes did not cast their votes, and 180 votes were declared invalid. The winner got 684 votes more than his opponent. The number of valid votes received by the winner is 42% of the number of registered voters cast their votes. Now friends, here it is said that the two candidates contested the election and the 30% of the registered voters did not cast their votes. It means 70% have casted their votes. So two candidates are there and 70% registered their votes. Let the number of valid candidates be X, and therefore the 70% of X have casted their votes. And it is said that 180 votes were declared as invalid. Therefore, the valid votes that will be equal to 70% of x. I am not writing of x because there is no need to write x or no need to assume x also. 70% of x minus 180, because these are the invalid votes, and therefore total valid votes will be 70%. It means 70% is the total casted votes minus 180 invalid votes, that will give you the total valid votes. Next, it is said that the winner got 684 votes more than his opponent. It means the difference between the winners and the opponent's votes is 684. That's enough. You will get the equation to get the value of x. So here we will apply this to get the equation that the winner got 684 votes more than his opponent. So we can write the equation as winner's votes minus into bracket valid votes minus winner's vote, that will be equal to 684. Whatever the winner got the votes subtracted the loser's vote. How will you get the loser's vote? Valid votes minus winner's vote, that you will get the opponent's votes. And therefore winner's votes minus into bracket valid vote minus winner's votes, that will be equal to 684. And therefore winner's vote are what? The number of valid votes received by the winner is 42% of the number of registered voters. So it will be 42% of x. I am not writing of x. Minus valid votes. Valid votes which got 70% of x minus 180. So it is 70% minus 180. Minus winner's vote. Winner's vote is what? It is 42% of x. So it is 42%. That will be equal to 684. And so this can be solved further as 42%. Now if you open this bracket, there is a negative sign. Outside the bracket, all the signs will change. And so this is 42%, this will be plus 42%, this will be minus 72%. So 42 plus 42, that will be 84%, minus 70%, that will be 14%. This will be minus and minus, this will become plus. If you shift it to other side, then that plus will again become minus. So 684 minus 180, that is equal to 684 minus 180, that is equal to 504. So we can say that 14% is 504, then 100%, that will be equal to how much? 14% is 504, therefore 100% will be how much? So we multiply these two and divide by the first one. So it will be 504 multiplied by 100 divided by 14. And that is equal to, so it is 3600. And therefore the number of registered voters will be 3600.